Hi folks, I'm here to talk about how to do data modeling for distributed Postgres in Azure Cosmos DB. I'm Sai Sriampur and I lead the customer engineering team for Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres. Before we get started, let's understand what is Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres. Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres is Azure's fully managed distributed SQL offering built upon the core benefits of Postgres. It stays native to Postgres, supporting the latest versions and the rich features, including JSONB data type, extensions like PostGIS, rich indexing, and so on. It is powered by the fully open source Citus extension to Postgres for distributed scale. To achieve distributed scale, Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres extends Postgres with the superpower of distributed tables. You can start small by building your apps on a single node, the same way you would with Postgres. As your app scale and performance requirements grow, you can seamlessly scale to multiple nodes by transparently distributing your tables. Create distributed table concurrently is the magic function that Cosmos DB Postgres provides to distribute tables across multiple nodes. Distributing tables to scale out to multiple nodes is all online. Reads and writes can go through as usual. That is, your app would have no impact when you distribute tables and scale out. Let's learn more about what distributing tables actually does under the covers. In a multi-node deployment, there are two types of nodes. One is the coordinator node and others are worker nodes. Coordinator node and worker nodes are nothing but simple plain Postgres databases with the Citus extension loaded. Your application connects to the coordinator node and interacts very similarly how it does with Postgres. The coordinator node is responsible for distributed planning. The worker nodes are the nodes where the actual data exists. That's where the actual computation happens. To distribute a table here, as an example, I'm distributing the campaigns table on the company ID using the create distributed table concurrently API. Once I run that command, the coordinator decomposes the campaigns table into multiple shards. Shards are nothing but simple plain Postgres tables that are on the worker nodes, which hold a subset of your data. Here, they would basically hold a subset of your companies because I'm distributing the campaigns on the company ID. When I run a query for a single company ID, the coordinator node automatically routes the query to the right worker node where the company exists and executes the query. Whereas if I run a query that spans across companies, the coordinator node parallelizes that query across multiple nodes, pushes the work as much as possible to the worker nodes, and does the execution. So if you see, distribution column lies at the heart of how Cosmos DB Postgres efficiently distributes data and executes queries. Choosing the right distribution column is an important step to effectively use the database. Here I have a slide that shows why distribution column, also called shard key, is so critical. First, shard key dictates the performance and scalability of your application because your data and queries are distributed based on that shard key. You don't want to pick a key that causes queue across the nodes, right? Because it won't be optimal for performance. Suppose I pick a column which represents 50% of the data, then I would basically get throttled or bottlenecked on a single node. You don't want to pick a key with low cardinality. Suppose I pick a column which has cardinality of 2, say I pick a Boolean column, right? Under the covers, you can scale only up to 2 nodes because the cardinality is 2. So you want to pick a column which has higher cardinality, mostly at least like in thousands. You want to pick a key that optimizes joins in your queries. So joining 2 tables with different shard keys can be slow, right? So you want to choose a common shard key across large tables. I'll do a drill down into this particular bullet point later in the slide. A column that incurs query parallelism is not always great. It is not optimal for transactional workloads because a query fan out is costly. It can cause network latency. Rather, you want to pick a column that routes queries to a single node. Whereas in analytical workloads, you want to pick a column in a way that your queries are parallelized across multiple nodes. So in summary, distribution column is a very important concept in Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres. Assuming that like we have understood how Cosmos DB Postgres distributes data, let's learn 5 tips for distributed data modeling with Postgres. First is column that adds natural dimension to data is a good shard key. We have seen this across customers where if they pick a column that represents the central piece of the application or lives at the heart of the application, most of the time it works out very well. Some good examples are, suppose you're building a SaaS app, right, where you have multiple customers and each customer interacts with their own data. Customer ID is the natural dimension, or it's the central piece of the application, and it can be a good candidate. Whereas I have an IoT app where, you know, I get data from devices, I analyze this data coming from devices, device ID, which is the heart of the application, is a good candidate. Here I have another example. Say I have an application which analyzes events on GitHub, and these events are actually generated by users on GitHub, right? In that application, the data model is pretty straightforward. I have the events table, I have users table, and I have a dimensions table, which is countries here. Events and users are application specific tables. That's where, you know, application data is stored, and countries is a small dimension table, right? In such application, user ID is a good candidate for distributing tables. The reason is because it is the central piece. Events are in fact generated by users themselves, and it adds natural dimension to the data, right? So user ID is a good pick for such a use case. The second tip I have is collocate large tables and make small tables reference. In the GitHub events example, if you see, I have the events and users table, and these are, as I said, the larger tables as they store application specific data. To collocate both these tables, I'm distributing them on the user ID. So if you see, the create distributed table concurrently has the user ID as the distribution column for both the tables. The countries table is smaller dimension table that is shared across users. So I can make the countries table a reference table. And in the Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres world, a reference table is a table that is replicated across all the nodes. I have talked so much about collocating tables. What does this actually mean and how does it help? If you see, I have distributed users and events on the same column, which is user ID, and this makes them collocated, which ensures that data for same users for both the tables is on the same node. This helps optimally perform SQL operations like joins and foreign keys in a distributed environment. For example, I do a join between users and events. That particular join, as you're seeing on the screen, can be pushed down across the shards directly to the worker nodes. So this would give you great performance because the join is very efficient. For countries table, as it is replicated across all the nodes, it can directly join with the users table, and that join also can be pushed down. Hence, collocation is a very important concept, and this tip suggests that you want to collocate large tables by distributing on the same column and make the smaller tables as reference or replicated tables. The third tip I have is use JSONB data type to store unstructured data. Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres natively supports the JSONB data type, and it helps you store semi-structured and unstructured data. The advantages are you have a simplified schema. So you can have a single table to store a variety of data. Say I have, like, you know, GitHub events data. And if you see, like, I have the payload, which is the JSONB column, I can store a variety of events in a single table. JSONB data type also has this thing called JIN indexing, and this helps you faster access to the JSONB. So you can search through the JSONB, you can query through the JSONB in a very optimal way. Next, you are basically adding NoSQL and document-like capabilities in a distributed Postgres world. And we've seen this work very well in implementing workloads that need scale. Say you have IoT, events, logs, where there is no structure to data and you want to store that, you basically use JSONB. The fourth tip I have is complement distribution of tables with time series partitioning. So in this example of GitHub events, here if you see, I have decided to distribute on user ID. Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres also gives you capabilities to partition distributed tables. So I can create, you know, a time-based partition. So here, if you see, I have multiple partitions for the GitHub events. I have, you know, partitions which are monthly. So I have a partition for July, August, September, January, February, etc. And Cosmos DB Postgres also lets you archive older partitions using columnar storage format. The newer partitions where you get real-time ingests and where you get majority of the queries are row-based, whereas the older partitions are columnar and they're compressed. The benefits of partitioning are it helps like filtered querying when there are like timestamp filters. There is efficient expiry because you can basically drop the table, drop the older partitions instead of like, you know, deleting the data. It also helps efficient archiving of older data. So I'm basically archiving the older data using columnar and saving storage costs. And last but not the least, we have seen this a lot in time series workloads where customers complement like, you know, distributing tables with time-based partitioning when there is a time dimension present. So the fifth, so here is an example. I mean, the Cosmos DB for Postgres supports, native time series APIs. And I have like APIs for automatic data partitioning, automatic data archival, and automatic data expiry. Under the covers, like say for automatic data partitioning, by just running this command, it creates partitions in the history and in the present. And in for archival, it automatically, you know, makes older partitions columnar. And for expiry, you just run this command, it would basically drop all the partitions that are older than the specified time. So the fifth tip, till now, whatever tips we have talked about are related to schema and table modeling, right? The fifth tip is more related to queries, right? Scope queries to shard keys where possible. So wherever possible, say in a SaaS workload, right? Like queries can be scoped to the tenant ID or the customer ID, make sure to add that particular column in the filter, right? So here I have an example where I'm, you know, updating a table with the ID as the filter that if, you know, you add the company ID filter, as this is a SaaS like multi-tenant workload, this would be much more efficient, right? Basically by this, you're avoiding unnecessary fan out and helping query latency, right? And this is more relevant in transactional workloads where you want to optimize network latency by, you know, having the distribution column present. So just to summarize, these are the five tips for distributed data modeling with Postgres. Tip one, column that adds natural dimension to data is a good shard key. Tip two, collocate large tables by distributing them on a common column and make smaller table reference. Third, to store unstructured and semi-structured data, use JSONB data type. Fourth, complement distributed tables by partitioning and on time whenever there's a time dimension. This is specifically when you have time series data. And tip five, scope queries to shard key where possible. If you follow these five tips, I'm pretty confident that you'll have a great experience with the product and you'll build like, you know, scalable operational apps with Azure Cosmos DB for Postgres. Happy testing. Thank you.